Howdy, everyone. We've often talked about how fast innovation is moving. It seems like wave after wave of technology is crashing over us. In this video, we're going to take a lighter approach and look at surfing and the lessons it offers to help us navigate today's rapid pace of change. Part of the relationship to surfing and waves is that technology often comes at us in waves and just like waves. The Economist Joseph Schumpeter in 1942 actually wrote a paper writing about disruption and disruptive waves and what he was seeing at that point of how innovation and technology was starting to impact society and business. And he really defined a set of waves that have been extended now to six waves. The first wave that you see, and these waves are all about technology. So they are technology waves. The first wave, which happened about 240 years ago, was really the Industrial Revolution. This is where machines and water power allowed us to build goods faster than having craftsmen individually do it themselves. So we were able to produce goods quickly. Then we get into the next two waves. The next two waves are really about transportation. This is the emergence of trains and steam power. This is the emergence of electricity to power factories. This is all about how do we extend our ability to manufacture goods and get the goods out to people wherever they're at, faster than if we had to use horse and buggy to get stuff. So now we're able to produce goods faster and get it to people faster. Then we start looking at our fourth wave. Now, in the fourth wave, we started seeing computers come. We saw electronics start emerging. We also saw airplanes emerging. So one, we were able to get goods even further and even faster and be able to manufacture them faster. So we're able to distribute. But we also saw the emergence of digital and information and being able to get access to information to do computations on in a much faster pace. And again, a lot of these trends, we're seeing them all deal with speed of building, speed of accessing, speed of information. That brings us to the fifth wave. Now, the fifth wave is really the internet. Up to this point, we had to push goods out, but we already saw in the fourth wave the emergence of information. Now we're taking that information and getting it out almost instantly everywhere that people might need it. And so this is really a huge explosion and a big wave that was all centered around connectivity. It also had components of software in it. If we really think about the internet, we started in 1990, kind of at the beginning of this wave, with 2.3 million people connected. And by the end, really in 2016, we saw 3.4 billion people connected. Now, the next wave starts in 2020. So it's fairly recent. We're kind of in the beginning of this wave. And this is the wave of AI. And how is AI transforming the way that we work to actually be faster and impact us in different ways by operating on the information faster. So we're in the middle of this wave. Now, the AI wave itself can actually also be broken down into a set of ways that kind of describe how it's emerged. And these are all the AI waves. And there's really just four major waves here. The first wave is the birth. This is around Alan Turing kind of coming up with the concept of AI at the very beginning of computing in 1950. That kind of went into a winter period where we oversold how good and how powerful AI could be. And we saw a lot of stuff in movies and it didn't really result. So we went into a winter. But then we started seeing an emergence at the end of the winter period where AI started coming stronger by using ML, by using machine learning. It also started using data to operate on. And we really saw this happen with the IBM Deep Blue in 1996 as it beat Kasparov in chess by taking information, learning, and being able to play chess and beat Kasparov. Then we kind of move into the modern area, in the modern way. This is really about deep learning. This is really taking it even further and start having systems like Alexa and Siri that can take information and respond to a query and actually show a consumer angle to this. All of this started building up into the wave that we're in now, which is a surge, a real surge of a lot of AI coming at us. And even this surge can be broken into its own minimal set of waves that we're seeing as part of that large surge wave. And so the set that we're seeing there is one, AI that can generate information for you. So it recognizes, it consumes a lot of data, recognizes patterns, and can show you patterns and trends, and we can operate off that. That was kind of the first wave in the surge that we saw. The second wave is that AI that can chat for you, that we actually see the emergence of large language models, of LLMs that can take billions of parameters and interact with people in a very natural way. Go get information and bring responses back. So we see AI that can chat with us. We ask a question and it can bring a lot of information back. This is Gen AI. This is the RAG models that we're seeing. Then we're seeing AI that can do for you. This is agentic AI. These are agents. These are agents that can actually go do actions on our behalf, not just bring us information, but actually do tasks. And it can do that in an autonomous way, and it can do that in a way that it learns from it. And then the next and final wave that we'll see in this surge is really around physical AI, where it comes out of the computers and we can physically interact with it. And of course, all of these AI waves are bringing a lot of stuff with us that we have to take into consideration. Do we use A2A? Do we use MCP? Do we use Copilot? Do we use, you know, LangChain? Do we use LangGraph? Like, how do we want to do this? And there's so many technologies available to us. And these describe all this surge, this tsunami of waves around AI that are coming at us. Okay, enough with waves of change, waves of innovation, and waves of AI. Let's start talking about what this means for the challenges we have and how we can learn from surfing. So let's start with the challenges that we have when we're adopting AI and how we see a lot of similarity in the challenges that we have in surfing. The first thing that we think about when we're adopting AI is, how do I start? A lot of times organizations don't even know where to begin with AI. And in some ways, it's the same with surfing. If I wake up and I want to go surfing today, it's like, well, do I want to do the break that's behind me? Do I want to drive down the beach? Do I want to drive an hour away? How do I want to do my surfing today? Where do I want to go? So very similar kind of challenge. Next thing we talk about is, we think about in adopting AI, is which technologies do I want to adopt and use? And this is, in the AI world, am I going to use LLMs? Am I going to use a chatbot? Do I want to do assistance? Am I just interacting and getting information? Do I want to figure out, am I going to build my solution or go buy my solution from a vendor? Or what framework do I want to build agentic? A lot of questions about technologies that we have to think about. Same thing in surfing. If I'm going to a break to surf, am I going to use a longboard today? Do I want to put my toes on the nose? Do I need to use a shortboard? Do I need to use a wetsuit? Do I need a rash guard? So there's all these questions about, what do I need to use today in my surfing session? Then we start asking about, okay, if I know the technology, do I have what I need to continue on? And this is really around, is my data ready? Is my data cleansed? Is it prepped and ready to use an AI system? Also, can we integrate it? If I bring in vendor systems and chatbots, can I actually integrate that with my legacy systems and make that work? I have the same kind of thing with surfing. If I know I'm going to be longboarding today, do I have the right wax? Do I have the right fin setup? Am I going with a 3-fin setup? What length leash do I need to use? So all of these things, once I know what I'm picking, then I kind of have to make sure that my whole setup is correct. Then we go and we say, do we have the right skills that we need to adopt AI? So, and this one, I feel like we've been talking about in a lot of different sessions. What skills do you need? What do you need to develop your models, to train your models? Are you doing Python training for your agentic systems? All of these things, do I have the skills? Same thing in surfing. If, what is the day gonna bring? Is this a big day? Do I have the skills for riding big waves? Is this a small day so that I don't really have to worry about it much? Or am I going to, like I said, use my longboard and just do some cruising? Or do I wanna do turns? And if I'm going to do the turns, switchbacks, do I have the skills to do that? So when I think about where, how I'm going to start and what I'm going to use, I also have to think about, do I have the skills to accomplish that? The next thing we think about when we're adopting is the timing. When do we need this? And a lot of times we really start rushing when we want to bring in AI. And it really is built a lot on, do we have the technology? Do we have what we need in place? Do we have the skills? Same kind of thing in surfing. If I just get up and say, hey, I'm going to go surf, I need to know what the tides are doing. Are the tides rising? Is it a high tide? Is it low tide? How does that impact where I'm going to surfing? Which direction is the wave coming from? What's the wind doing? Is the wind picking up or is it calm and everything is glassy? So the timing of whether I'm adopting AI or surfing is also extremely critical. The other thing that we really start thinking about is organizational resistance. And this is really a cultural thing. As it kind of showed with the waves, it's coming at us really fast. We're in a surge. We're in a tsunami of technology and capabilities that are coming at us. And there can be some resistance to say, well, we need to slow the timing down. We need to pause. We need to understand what's happening. And so you can see an organizational resistance starts coming up to prevent you from doing the adoption. And same kind of thing happens in surfing. Depending on where I decide I'm going to go and what I'm going to need to do, how friendly is that break? Is it a friendly break and I can go out and there's no issues? Or is it a very local break, which is going to require a bunch of different skills to have to adopt to, you know, the resistance that I have from fellow surfers? So these are some of the challenges that we really come across when we're adopting AI. So what are the things that we can do and lessons that we have learned from surfing that can help us with this? Well, the first thing that we do is, what are you trying to do? And this is a question that you have to ask yourself, either surfing or in business. And it really is, in the surfing world is, as I kind of described, what am I trying to do? Am I trying to go big? Am I trying to small? Am I trying to go long? Am I trying to do a shore break? In business world is, what are the outcomes? What is it that you're trying to accomplish? We shouldn't start by saying, oh, AI is here. We've got to do AI. So let's just start applying all these technologies at it. No, you should really say, what are you trying to do? What are the outcomes you're trying to accomplish? Same thing that we do when we go out surfing. The next thing is, be ready. Now, when I first started surfing, I would go out and I would start paddling and trying to get into a wave. And I didn't think I had the arm strength, right? I was missing waves. They were going through me. I was going early. I was purling. And I really thought it was because of a lack of arm strength to get me onto the wave. What I found out is it really doesn't have that much to do with arm strength. I mean, it does play into it, but it's really about being in the right position at the right time. Having the information about knowing, where's the wave breaking? Am I closer to the pink and not off the shoulder? Am I starting my pedal at the right time? Well, I will catch it at the right time. So be ready is a lot about skills and technologies and having that available, but it's also about being at the right place at the right time. And part of that is to look two steps ahead. One of the things that I had happen to me in surfing is, I'm sitting out there, there's not a lot happening during a day, and finally some waves come. And I say, well, I'm not taking the first wave, I take the next wave because I'm anxious and I want to get on the wave. So I get on it and I ride. But then I see behind it are some great waves. These are waves that I missed because I just wanted to get going, right? And a couple things happen. I either miss a great wave or a big sec comes in and I'm caught inside in the impact zone and I get pummeled. So you need to kind of think ahead a little bit about where you want to be. So what are you trying to do? What are your outcomes? But also look ahead. Where are we going to be in a few steps? Don't rush to adopt a technology that may be the wrong technology up front when you should wait a little bit and get the right technology. So think about where you're going. And this also plays into be patient. I know these waves are coming fast. I know they're coming at a rapid pace. But if you've got the right skills, if you're ready, if you're kind of planning where you need to be patient and let it happen. Let it come to you. Wait for the right wave to come. And when that happens, then you seize the opportunity. Go for it. Jump in and take it. You know you're ready. You know you've planned. You know you look ahead. You've waited for the right moment. You have the right set of skills and technology for your outcome you're trying to do. And then you go for it. And surfing, we kind of call this go big or go home, right? And you don't necessarily want to go big or go home in business. But the point is the same. You need to embrace it and you go for it. And this can start pushing in some ways against the organizational resistance because you need to, you take the risk, which there's a little bit of resistance for, but you're doing it in a way where you're ready for it. So seize the opportunity. When you seize the opportunity, you then need to embrace change and adapt. Every wave is different. You ride one wave and it goes a certain way. You go out, you take the next wave, completely different. And so you're constantly finding yourself having to change. Okay, this is different. It's coming a slightly different angle, or it's breaking a little bit different. So I have to adapt and change. AI is the same way. The technologies, as they keep emerging, they're going to be a little bit different. They're going to be accomplishing similar goals, but in a different way. You have to be able to adapt and change as these waves of technology are coming, much like I do when we're riding surf. And then the final thing is to learn from failure. A lot of surfing is crashing, not getting up, doing something wrong, whatever it is that happens, and you learn from that. You adapt and change, you learn, you get back up, and you keep going, right? And you do something different. And that's because the waves are keep coming, right? In technology, the waves are going to keep coming. So you have to kind of do this little cycle here of seizing the opportunity, have everything ready, seize the opportunity, embrace the change, learn from it, and keep going. And if you do all this, then you'll position yourself in a really great position to embrace everything. And the final thing, there is one more final thing. In surfing, cheer people on. AI, in this wave of AI, is really kind of once in a lifetime, once in a generation wave that's coming at us. And it's going to be intense. It's going to be hard. There's going to be failures. Cheer people on. In surfing, when somebody does catch that great wave, you cheer them on. All right. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you like the analogy between surfing and technology. And now go out there and rip it.